So I also wanted to talk about who died in the movie and then who stayed alive, and then the questionables. We are unsure. So I have created a list. On my list, I have split up all of the characters into 5 different categories. Everybody that disappeared died after the snap. Everybody that died before the snap. All of the characters that are still alive. The to-be-determined characters, but we're not sure if they made it or not. And the missing no-clue characters. They didn't show up at all in this movie, so we have no idea what happened to them. So let's talk about these a little bit. So I have a philosophy, or a theory, I wouldn't say philosophy, a theory on how this second movie is going to go. So I believe that everybody who died after the snap is going to come back. I mean, there's just so many clues and tells for why that's going to happen. One, most of these people all have second movies. We know Doctor Strange has a second movie coming out. We know Black Panther has a second movie coming out. There's no way Marvel's going to kill him. He's their, like, juggernaut moneymaker right now. We know Spider-Man has a second film. We know all of Guardians of the Galaxy has Volume 3 coming out. However, I will say would not be surprised if they actually leave Gamora dead, and then Guardians of the Galaxy is just teenage Groot, or he might be adult Groot by then, Drax, Mantis, and Star-Lord. You know, there's all this talk about Bucky or Falcon taking over the mantle of Captain America, so I'm pretty sure one of those guys is coming back. So basically, even though those deaths were kind of hard to watch, especially Spider-Man's death, because him begging not to die was pitiful. It hit you in the feels. It did kind of help to know that they all have movies coming up, so somehow in the next film they're going to have to find a way to bring him back, so you can kind of reconcile that their deaths are just temporary. The deaths that I think are done, one and done, like they ain't coming back: Heimdall, Loki, Gamora, Vision. Loki, like I said in my last film, like, really made me sad. I love Loki. He's like a great villain, anti-villain, whatever you want to call him, god of mischief. I love Tom Hiddleston's character. So watching Loki, like, you know, fight it in the first 10 minutes of the film was just kind of like, dang, Loki. Vision, unless they can go back in time, I'm pretty sure he's gone. Not really upset about that one. Gamora, that's sad. Like, you know, you can't have Guardians of the Galaxy without Gamora, so I really wonder if they're going to keep her dead or not, but I wouldn't be surprised if they do. And then, of course, Heimdall. I really liked Heimdall's character. First of all, I like Idris Elba, but I liked his character just in the story anyway, so that was sad. But it was cool. I mean, not cool, but it was like he was willing to sacrifice himself to do what needed to be done. What I did find interesting was basically all the characters that are still alive are basically the original old guard of the Avengers. So you have Captain America, Iron Man, Thor, Hulk, Black Widow. You know, War Machine was first introduced with Iron Man. And so you got Black Panther's, like, right-hand people, Okoye and M'Baku. I think it's interesting that the counter to Gamora and Nebula made it. And then Rocket, being a raccoon, is the only one left of the Guardians of the Galaxy at this point. So I basically have a theory that a lot of these people who are still alive are going to have to die in order to bring these guys back. And I kind of looked at everybody was kind of paired up, like Bucky and Captain America, Falcon and War Machine, Iron Man and Peter Parker for Spider-Man. So I feel like these guys are going to have to sacrifice something, basically their lives, to get these guys back. I believe that the Time Stone and the Soul Stone are going to be heavily used in the second film to bring these characters back. Let's talk about the to be determined. Last we saw Shuri at the end of the movie, she was fighting off some aliens coming in to try to get her in Vision. I'm gonna guess that she made it. They didn't show us one way or the other, but I think it would be kind of weird to kill both her and Black Panther, so I think it makes more sense to keep her alive. Obviously, we're gonna assume that Captain Marvel made it, even though she's not in this film at all, but it looks like she's supposed to appear in the next movie. So obviously that means she probably did not dissipate wherever she is in the universe or realm. So we're gonna go with her. Now, Goddess of Death is interesting. Like, it is assumed that she died at the end of Thor Ragnarok because of how Asgard was destroyed, but she is like a god, and who knows, like, she might not get her power from Asgard anymore, but she might have found some way to survive that destruction of Asgard, which would be an also interesting play, because we know that Thanos is in love with death, and I don't think it's necessarily Hela in the comics, but that would be a cool twist if somehow Hela was involved with what happens in the second movie. Also the Grandmaster, we don't know what happened to him. They don't show him at all in this movie, so we don't know what happens to him or the people on his planet. And the Collector, like I said, Thanos, he looks like he destroyed Nowhere to bring the Collector to get the Reality Stone, but we don't really know what happened to the Collector. We don't know if he got off the planet beforehand. Maybe Thanos is keeping him somewhere, who knows? So he's also to be determined. Are missing no clue. We have Hawkeye, Ant-Man, Valkyrie, Krog, and Meek. I was really looking forward to seeing Valkyrie in this film. I really liked her character, Thor Ragnarok. First of all, I think Valkyries are just super awesome characters. I do think it's interesting that I thought Valkyrie was going to show up in the film because she was such a main character in Thor Ragnarok, so I was kind of, you know, sad that she wasn't there, because I'm like, team girl, team Valkyrie. And Ant-Man and Hawkeye not being there is just kind of weird. Like, I don't know if they purposely did that, but like, Hawkeye was in the original Avengers movie, so at least he should have at least been in this film. I don't know what kind of half-assed excuse they came up with there's some on some mission because they got in trouble with the government at the end of Civil War, so they made a deal with the government. What mission are they doing? And I don't know. It just doesn't seem to align with what Ant-Man and the Wasp is going to be about. Maybe that's what they're working on. Maybe Hawkeye is going to be in the Ant-Man and the Wasp movie. Who knows? I do know that I've heard that the Ant-Man and the Wasp is supposed to take place between, like, the old Ant-Man movie and Thor in the Infinity War. So I'm wondering if, like, Ant-Man's still going to be around by the end of his movie, or if he's going to dissipate, or either him or the Wasp are going to dissipate at the end of their film. Either way, I hope they bring Hawkeye back. I mean, I know he's not one of the main superhero characters. I mean, he is to me, because he's one of the OG. So it was just weird that he wasn't in it, and we just had so many other characters. Like, I really could not have Scarlet Witch in a movie. I'm just not a fan. I don't know. Just not a fan. Anyway, and we don't know what happened to Krog or Meek. I'm thinking, like, that's the other half of that ship that they made it away. And because half of them didn't make it, the ones that were still there. And it looks like half of them made it off in some other ship. Maybe there was another ship there. So I guess we're going to find out in the next movie, Avengers 4, which is still untitled. However, until then, there will be tons of speculation on where these characters are and what happened to them. Anyway, what do you guys think? What do you think about the deaths in the film? Who do you think is going to be dead, not come back at all? Who do you think they're going to bring back? And what are your thoughts on how they're going to do it? Because, you know, clearly they're going to have to reverse those deaths just based on how the movies are coming out in phase 4, I think we're in. So how do you think they're going to do it? Tell me in the comments. And also, if you like this video, please subscribe. Thanks.